सिंदूरारुण विग्रह त्रिनयन माणिक्य मौली स्फुरत्
नमस्ते। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुर्साक्षात् परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। Very warm welcome to each of you present here on a very auspicious day of the Guru Purnima. It's a day when we revere and offer our sincere gratitude to the entire tradition of the Guru Parampara or the lineage of the Gurus. And we are starting this day today with our humble offering to the greatest of Gurus, the Supreme Beings themselves, to Lord Dakshinamurti, to Lord Shiva, who are the founders of this movement of yoga, and then from there on to the enlightened masters, from the enlightened masters to our own teachers, from our own teachers to all those who have served to give us any kind of knowledge in any form in our lifetimes that have enabled us to become who we are today. So we have a very special presentation today on the importance of Guru Parampara by none other than Dr. Ramachandran Bhatt. So I request Vinaya to come in and please introduce Acharya to you.
Namaste. Acharyanam Ramchandra Bhattanam Sankshepataha Aham Samskate Parichayam Karayami Ado Tatav Param Angla Bhashayam. I'll introduce Acharyaji in Sanskrit initially and then give him a detailed introduction about him in English. Ete Santi Vedavijnana Gurukulasya Samsthapakaha Bengaluru Nagarasya Anadhika Dure Vartate Etad Gurukulam Vedavijnana Gurukulam Yatra Chhatraha Arshavidyam Adhunika Vidyancha Samyak Sametya Patanti Tasya Gurukulasya Samsthapakaha Tadvadeva Karnataka Pradeshe Gurukulatrayam Vidyate Etat Vedavijnana Gurukulam Tadvadeva Balikanam Krite Maitreyi Gurukulam Iti Mangaluru Samipe Punaha Shringagiri Samipe Hariharapura Nagare Grame Prabodhini Gurukulam Iti Tattu Balakanam Krite Vartate Evam Trayanam Gurukulanam Samsthapakeshu Anyatamaha Punaha Gurukula Prakalpasya Sanchalakaha api asan, Tadvadeva adhuna Bhartiya Shikshana Mandalam iti vartate, Bhartiya Shikshana Mandalasya Akhila Bharatiya Gurukula Prakalpasya Pramukhaha api ete santi, Tadvadeva Vedavijnana Gurukulastha Vedavijnana Shodha Samsthanam iti Shodha Kendram yadvartate, Tat Shodha Kendrasya api ete Pramukhaha Adhyakshaha Tatra Santi Tadvadeva Bengaluru Nagare Eva Vishwe Atyantam Manitam Vishwavidyalayaha Vartate Yasvyasa Yoga University Yasvyasa Yoga University Vishwavidyalayasya Ete Bhutapurva Kulaguravaha Asan Iti Parichayam Karayitum Atyantam Momudyate Me Manaha Etesham Parichayah Punaha Angla Bhashayam Karayami. Acharya Ramchandra Bhatji is with us. It's indeed an honor to have him here on this occasion. He is the one who has gifted light to many, many youngsters, including me. Many of us have been his students. We were fortunate enough to grow under his mentorship. He is the one who lifted us from nowhere and brought us to certain levels. He is the founder of Vedavijnana Gurukulam, a unique educational system that is based in Bangalore, which blends traditional as well as modern education and prepares students for tomorrow with an in-depth knowledge of Sanskrit and Shastras and also giving them contemporary perspectives. He is the visionary founder of that Gurukulam. And there is also a Vedavijnana Shodha Samsthanam, a dedicated research center, which is an extended unit of Vedavijnana Gurukulam, of which he is the current chairman, where research is happening in the areas of Indic studies, in the Shastra studies, bringing them into contemporary relevance. And similarly, there is also a pan-Indian organization called Bharatiya Shikshana Mandalam, which is dedicated to revive the Indianness in education or the spiritual traditions in education. And of that organization, there is a dedicated wing which looks into reviving Gurukulam education called Akhila Bharatiya All India Gurukul Education Board or Gurukula Education Platform, of which again he is the head and serving as its president too. And He is also the retired vice chancellor or a former vice chancellor of S. Vyasa Yoga University, a world-renowned university based in Bangalore, which is known for contributions in the field of yoga. As many might know, more than 70 to 80% of the papers that are published in the field of yoga have come out of this university. He has led that university into great achievements in last 6 to 7 years. And it's indeed an honor, a fulfilling experience to have him this morning with us. So with this very brief introduction, I request Acharya ji to enlighten us on the importance of Guru Parampara, an auspicious day that he is with us. And just to add, these were just some of the responsibilities that he has held, but along with it, what the credit that goes to him is his ability to lead or mentor youngsters for last 30, 40 years that he's been teaching, that he's been into the field of research. One thing that he enjoys most is to work with youth, to connect with them and be able to guide them in the proper direction. So there are hundreds of youth who have that connection strongly with him and would seek his guidance at every important moment of their lives. And Acharya ji is here with us. And I now request Acharya ji to give or share his insights on this occasion.
अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां कृष्ण द्वैपायनं वंदे सर्व लोक हिते रतं वेदांत भास्करं वंदे समाधि निलयं मुनिं This day, very auspicious day, is mainly meant for offering our pranams to the whole lineage started from the great sages like Marichi, Sanaka, Sanandana, etc. We are very proud because we have inherited that perennial stream of Jnana Dhara, knowledge stream. This stream started from three Murti, Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara. It is very much interesting and unique to know how we attach importance to that source of inspiration, source of motivation to take up Vedanta based, yoga based vision for our action and our life mission. When we think about Guru Parampara. First of all, what and why and who, and the ultimate last important question is how. Let us proceed further in a very grand, graded manner. What is Guru Parampara? Guru is that mankind, Guru is that great soul which imparts the second birth to his people, his men. So Guru, yaha kriyah kritva vedamasmai prayachati. He becomes the great Guru, one who gives the second birth. So that second birth, it is to be imparted and it is to be commissioned. It is to be initiated. When someone is just 8 years old or 12 years old. So by imparting this second birth, he becomes the real guru. So that is the answer, who is guru? Then we come to this parampara part. Parampara is that perennial unbroken tradition which comes to the present day. Parampara. Param means the highest one, and it is also again comparative. So again, we have a lot of scope and hopes for superlative stages. Param parang gacchama, parat parang gacchama. That is the culmination, highest peak of achievement of mankind. So parampara must help for this excellence. So now we take up that. Who is the real guru? Already I have told three gurus. That is, they are also gurus by inspiring their own lineage. For example, Sadashiva Samarambham, Shankaracharya Madhyamam, Asmadacharya Paryantam, Vande Guru Parampara. That is one type of lineage originated from Shiva Shakti. Shiva Shakti. So there we have many great sadhakas. Just like Gaudapada Acharya, the Parameshi Guru, Paramaguru, like that we have that tradition. So that non-dualistic Advaita Parampara, it was projected, portrayed in the real sense, inspired by great Sadashiva, Dakshinamurti. That one, it comes to this level also, we have the tradition unbroken, we see this, all three, Prasthana Traya, Brahma Sutra, 10 major Upanishads, Bhagavad Gita. When we come to that Vishnu-oriented lineage, there comes the great Vyasa, Narayanam, Padmabhuvam, Vasishtham, Shaktim, Parasharam, Vyasam, Shukam. That is how this lineage, it comes to our level. Asmadacharya, our own great gurus, those who give this auspicious spiritual jnanam vijnanam. Tadishaha guravaha, asmadacharyaha. This is number two. Here again, we have one more division. It is called Narasimha Guru. Narasimha Guru. So Narasimha Guru, one of the incarnations of Vishnu, he is considered to be guru for some people. Some followers, they consider like that. So that Vajranakha, Tikshna Damustra, that type of combination, blend of both Kshatra, Brahma, that Rupa, Nara, Simha, man and lion. That Guru Parampara also we have inherited. So both Idam Brahmam, Idam Kshatram, Shapadapi, Sharadapi. That is how Shapa Shakti and Shara Shakti, knowledge force and valor, both will be combined. And in Shiva Parampara, Shiva originated Parampara, we have one more, that is Datta Guru Parampara. Dattatreya, son of Atri, Anasuya, he is considered to be the great master of Vedanta and Yoga mainly. That is another Parampara. That Parampara also now it is very much followed somewhere in Maharashtra and Northern Karnataka. Datta Parampara. and another parampara, it is originated from none other than Hiranyagarbha Brahma. That is very well portrayed in Mundakopanishad. Brahma devanam prathamas sambhuva vishvasya karta bhuvanasya gupta sabrahma vidyam sarva vidya pratishtham atharvaya jyeshtha putraya praha. That is how Brahma Hiranyagarbha Saptama Loka Vasi, the seventh layer, as it is very well projected by Maharishi Aurobindo, that great divine head, that is the origin of this parampara, but it is coming to our level through Atharva Veda parampara. Pippaladavan, who was the greatest spiritual master, he shared his knowledge with six disciples. That is what Prashnopanishad tells us. That is another parampara. That is how Trimurti originated. Three stream, the real parampara, guru parampara in the real sense. Now we have Vyasa. Vyasa is considered to be the incarnation of Vishnu, but in him, all these three forces, Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, three forces blended. Achaturu vadano Brahma, Divahula paru Harihi, Apalalochana Shambhur Bhagavan Badarayana. So Badarayana Vyasa represents all these three streams. Here three streams, what is that importance attached to this, we have to understand. One is Yoga Parampara, another one is Yaga Parampara, and the third one is Tyaga Parampara. That is how these three streams are structured. This insight we have to imbibe now. Yoga Parampara, it is originated from Shiva Shakti, Maheshwara, Sadashiva. So he is called Dakshina. That is Yoga Parampara. There are many, many sub-paramparas in yoga. Mantra-oriented yoga parampara, tantra-oriented yoga parampara also there. That parampara also originated from Shiva. That is what very well protected by Swatma Rama in his Hatha Yoga Pradipika. And he has mentioned more than 20 such great gurus, tantra sadhakas up to the present time. Asmad Acharya Paryanta. Asmakam Acharya Paryantam Api Paramparayaha Varnanam Karoti Sah. Yoga Parampara originated from the Upanishads. Kathopanishad, Shvetashvatara, and so many. So that Shiva is considered to be great yogi. Yoginam yogi. Talsha Parampara, that type of parampara, is one yoga stream. Now you come to yaga stream. Yaga means yajna. Yajna Vishnu. Very popular statement. So great Vishnu Swarupa embodies that yajna parampara. Yajna parampara, it is just sharing and caring. All yajnas, five yajnas, Manushya yajna, Bhuda Yajna, Brahma Yajna, Pitri Yajna, Deva Yajna. All these yajnas very well portrayed in the third, fourth, fifth chapters of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. That yajna are yaga parampara. That lineage has come down to our level also. Now also our people, even our Gurukula, Chhatras, students also perform so many yajna yagas. Every year we conduct Samhita Yaga, taking one after one, Ruk, Yaju, Sam. Another three, it is called, another stream, Ruk Parampara, Yaju Parampara, Yaju Parampara, Sam Parampara, and Atharva is very much common too. Brahma Parampara, it is called. So, Parampara has so many sub-streams, main streams, now I am projecting three, corresponding to three. Three Murti and three forces, three guidelines, Yaga, Yoga and Tyaga. And when we come to Brahma Parampara, that is called Rishi Parampara, that it has its own mantra, it is Tyaga. So that Sannyasi Parampara very much guided by Hiranyagarbha. So it mainly embodies that Tyaga, living for others. Because Brahma is considered to be Jiva, Uttama Jiva, the highest refined individual soul. So these three streams, Yoga stream, Yaga stream, and Tyaga stream, that is to be kept intact now in this modern age. So while performing Vyasa Purnima and Guru Purnima, we must understand. Now I take up that how question. What? Why also I just partly nurtured? It is for human excellence. It is for divinizing the whole human life in totality. Dhyayam kim, uddeshyam kim, lakshyam kim, Guru Paramparaya. That part I taking that question, interrogative question, why? What Guru is and why that Guru lineage to be maintained even now in this modern world? And how question? How? You know, now we have three gakaras, problem areas. One is roga. Why roga? Why this much disease? Why we are talking so much about this pandemic and so many new phrases, new words emanated now? Why is this much roga? And it is because of raga, too much greed. Always roga originates from raga. This raga leads to bhoga also, consumerism. Bhoga vadaha, bhoga pravritti hi ragatah jaye. Asha hi paramam nidanam. Ashayaha ye dasaha te dasaha sarvalokasya. That is how this so-called modern man became slave of his own greed. That is why it is too much bhoga. Bhoga originated from raga, passion, misunderstanding. And going away from natural balance, eco-balance. All this leads to so much chaos. That is why these three gakaras, bhoga gakara, raga gakara, and roga gakara. These three gakaras are the main problems of this world, today's world. And for this we have to go for unlocking. How to unlock? We are talking about locking and unlocking, releasing, and post COVID-19 yuga. Now we have to understand that yuga and yuga sandhi, and how this yuga sandhi, it must pave the way for yuga parivartana, renaissance, new renaissance. There were many renaissance. Whenever this parampara, guru parampara is rejuvenated, then immediately there was a renaissance, a dawn of a new chapter. When it was Vyasa in Mahabharata time, before that when Vasishtha was in Rama's time, like that there were so many great Marichi Adi Rishis, Kashyapa Adi Rishis, when it was Krita Yuga. In all yuga ages, such great masters, they incarnate and they bring new revolution that is called Renaissance. In this age, again, there are so many great masters, yoga masters like Shivananda Saraswati, Paramahansa Yogananda, such great masters of 20th century, and there are many, many such great masters even now in this 21st. And there are many people practicing yoga. Many people, they are there in the Himalayas, in caves, in the mountains, on the bank of rivers, in so many ashramas, mathas, gurukulas, but they do sadhana. For Loka Kalyana, they do sadhana. Such great masters also to be honored, remembered, and revered. That is the day. That is significance attached to this day now. So, now how to come out of all these menace, phobia, mania, so many problems, mental imbalances. Now we bring this yaga, yoga, and chakra, these three mantras for new renaissance. New renaissance in the post COVID-19. For that, we have to prepare. Even great masters like Yukteswar Giri Maharaj, great guru of Paramahansa Yogananda, and Maharshi Shivananji Maharaj, Divine Life Society, and so many great masters, Maharshi Aurobindo, and great Vasishtha Ganapati Muni, his Guru Ramana Maharshi, his Shishya Maharshi Devarata, they all predict that time will come, testing time will come, because this is the juncture period, Yugasandhi Kala. But it paves the way for Yuga Parivartha, new renaissance. Maharshi Aurobindo emphatically, clearly declared, he gave this clear call to be prepared for new renaissance. Now that time has come. Now while celebrating this year, Guru Parampara Day, Vyasa Puja Day, Guru Puja Day, we must carry this message and we must share this message with all, so that we can inspire all those in trouble, all those in dilemma, and all those who are the auspicious people and practitioners of yoga, yaga, we have to inspire them. This day is meant for that. We all be prepared. Adhyavayam yogam yagam anatishthama ratararabhyeva dakshinamurtisannidhau karyamarabdham asmin gurukule मध्यान्येपि दक्षिणामूर्ति यागः भवति अधः एतां गुरुपरम्परां स्मारं स्मारं एताश गुरुपरम्परा वचनानि श्रावं श्रावं अद्यतनीय लोकस्य दृश्यं दर्शं दर्शं वयम् अग्रे सरावः इति अहं प्रार्थये सर्वान् ये भागभाजः अत्र ज्ञानसंवहने अपि च ये च आस्तिकाः वैज्ञानिकाः विद्वांसः वैदिकाः तेभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमः गुरुपरम्परायै नमोऽस्तु नित्यं लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु ओम स्वस्ति
नमस्ते आचार्य बहु धन्यवादाः सूत्रत्वेन किंकर्तव्यता बोधितं योग याग त्यागः इत्येव अस्माकं मार्गः भवेत् इतः परं पोस्ट पैंडेमिक काले इति
मंत्र
आचार्य जी जस्ट गेव अस द मंत्र ऑफ व्हाट कुड बी द गाइडलाइन फॉर द न्यू एज दैट इज एमर्जिंग वी आर गोइंग थ्रू अ वेरी इंटेंस ट्रांजिशन फेज and we are not aware what is yet to come, what is there on the other side of this bridge that we are trying to cross at the moment. And Acharya ji says the guideline, what will help us is to follow these principles of yoga, yaga, and tyaga. This will be the way of the future, which is also a reminder of the new renaissance that is yet to come, as predicted, as mentioned by great sages and masters like Sri Aurobindo and many others. So this was the message. Maybe I'll just go to him with a question, and then by the time we might have a couple of questions from our participants also. In the lineage or in the Guru Parampara, Dakshinamurti is held in high esteem. Not many are familiar about Dakshinamurti, the Vidya Swarupa, the Guru Swarupa of Shiva. Maybe I request you to explain a little more about Dakshinamurti, his ways of teaching, and his importance in the lineage of Guru Parampara.
Welcome, Swagatam. First of all, I mentioned the souls for real understanding of Dakshinamurti and its lineage. Among 108 Upanishads, Dakshinamurti Upanishad is also there. That is very short, very precise. It is like aphorism. That Upanishad can be studied. That is one resource, reference for it. There, it is well told, clearly mentioned that Dakshina means it is the right part of human brain, which is the center for spiritual awakening. Spiritual awakening. Dakshina Shemushi Prokta. Shemushi means that positively charged human brain power. That is embodied in the form of Ishana. Lord Shiva got five faces. One is Sadyojat, recently born child. It is very much named for its mugdhata, innocence, shuddhata. Dvitiyam, the second one is Vamadeva. It is an embodiment of Rishi culture. Rishi culture in the means preservation of Veda lineage. Sadyojata and Vamadeva. And the third one is Tatpurusha. It is Aghora. Aghora is, it is more Ghora. What is that Ghora means? Just it is that force which takes care of Asuri Shakti and eliminates those negative forces from the arena of this whole world global scenario. That is why Aghora Shakti to be honored and to be worshipped today. Aghorebhyo, thagorebhyo, ghora ghora tarebhya. That is how Veda portrays that Ishwariya Tattva, Shiva Tattva. And Tatpurusha is there. Again, it embodies that whole Jeevanash. All type of human beings and other Jalachara, Sthalachara, Navashchara, all Jeevanash. And the fifth phase, that is Ishana, is Sarva Vidyana, Ishwara Sarva Bhudana. So Ishana, Dakshinamurti, these are different names given to this Ishwariya Shiva Shakti. So it takes care of Paravidya, Yata Dakshinamadhigam, Adhyatma Vidya. So Dakshinamurti, that is why always sits under banyan tree, Vatavraksha. That Vatavraksha also symbolizes awakening of knowledge. Vruddha Shishyaha Guru Yuva, that Yuva he was, because in Shiva's personality there was Rajas Virabhadra Tattva, that Virabhadra Rajasika went away from his Daivika Swarupam, that Purana is, Katha is there. So when Shiva becomes so pure, away from Tamas and Rajas, only he embodies that excellence. Climax of sattva, then he becomes Dakshinamurti. So in that form, he will be just like an adolescence, Dvadasha Varshiya Kumaraha, Kumara Bhava in Sanskrit. That Kumara Bhava, he sits under Nagrodha or banyan tree, then Sanaka Sanandaraj, all seekers of Adhyatma Vidya come and take that Adhyatma Vidya. That's how Srimad Bhagavatam tells. That particular Daivika Rupam is called Dakshinamurti.
Thank you, Acharya. You also mentioned one very important point during the presentation. You were referring to the runas, various runas that we carry as individuals. Or you said it in the other way, the Deva runa, Pitra runa, or the yajnas that we perform. So can you please tell the Pancha Yajnas that you were mentioning? I think that is something that most of us are very keen to know more. So could I request you to explain that a little more and also connect it with the runas that we carry as individuals?
Good. Both are interlinked, no doubt. When we think about yajna, we must refer to Taittiriya Aranyaka Swadhyaya Brahman. That is the main reference for insightful understanding of five-table yajnas. First of all, we must understand. Panchama Ete Maha Yajnaha, that is how that Brahmana, that portion of Veda from Taittiriya Aranyaka starts. What is that? What is Manushya Yajna, first of all? Now we are all Manushyas. It is sharing and caring. What we have, what we possess, that is to be shared with many people. That is where the question of Runa also comes. We have even Samaja Runa. All those farmers and all those agriculturists, they do something, they nourish this nature and they only give grains, all foodstuff, everything. That is why we have many, many runas. Daiva runa, Rishi runa, Pitra runa, these are all popularly known. And Guru runa also there, that is how we call it, Ekaksharam. One letter, one who gives, that is great guru, that is our Brahma. So all indebtedness, that is very important value even in the modern world also. So when we share and take care of many co-travelers in the sense all type of plants and animals, birds, all those. That is one. That is Bhutayajna. Manushyajna already taking care of mankind, their well-being, their welfare, for that whatever we contribute, that is Manushyajna. And what we share with co-travelers, that is called Bhutayajna. And we are very much, entrusted with maintaining our own family lineage. In this particular Bharatavarsha, Jambudvipa, every family got its own unique vidya. Something Brahma vidya, Vijnana vidya, Jnana vidya, and at the same time Vaidikiya vidya, Yantra vidya, Tantra vidya, Dhatu vidya, Rasa vidya, innumerable branches. So in that family lineage, all those vidyas are maintained so far. But now, because of this blind following of Western culture, our young generation is not interested in maintaining their own family tradition. That is why Sangeetha Vidya and so many vidyas are vanishing. Grandfather is great, father also may be great, but his son and his grandson may be interested somewhere else. Then that vidya lineage will be broken. That's why that part we have to seriously think how to maintain that. That is why Gurukulam. That is why we have this national, international project, Gurukula Prakalpa. The main aim and objective is this, to preserve all these vidyas. Srimad Madhvacharya says, Kotyam Shopina Vidya. Quote, crores of such vidyas, such secret and sacred medicinal understandings, they were kept in their family and often that vanished. That is why preservation of this is called Brahma Yajna. When we go for Pitri Yajna, there we have to maintain family tradition, that Vidya, and Brahma Vidya, Brahma Yajna, when we go, we take that knowledge and pass on to the next generation. That is Brahma Yajna. So Manushya Yajna, Brahma Yajna, Pitri Yajna, Bhuta Yajna. And another one very important, that is Deva Yajna. There we have to take this Yaga, performing Yajna and Yaga and we have to purify this whole antariksha. Because of this so much pollution, radiation and contamination, we are vulnerable and victims to all this now. That's why so many problems. So first of all, we must make our antariksha atmosphere free from all things. For that yajna is the only way, not yoga. Yoga is for purification of Dhanda. Yaga is the main thing, panacea for purification of atmosphere. So yoga and yaga, both must be properly taken care of. Then we will be free from these runas, deva, runya, runa. Rushi runa is that one. What we understand, that part to be imparted to the next generation. That is how this, as you told, both the yajna concept and runa concept, they are intertwined, and understanding will be very much comprehensive when we understand like this. Okay, I'm not listening to you now.
Sorry. Thank you, Acharyaji. Before I go to the next question, I would just like to summarize this once more, what Acharyaji mentioned, that each one of us, we carry certain rina, certain indebtedness towards the sources or the forces which have made our life possible. That is the Devaruna. So being grateful and express that gratitude in every way that we can, that is called Devaruna. And the second one is Pitruruna, the indebtedness that we carry to our ancestors and to our parents, which again should be expressed in the form of continuing our family lineages. That is the Pitruruna. And the third one, what he was referring to, was Acharya Runa, the Runa or indebtedness that we carry towards our teachers. Our whole culture has been kept alive. The tradition of yoga, the tradition of Vedanta has been kept alive by the sacrifice of innumerable teachers. And just to remember that and to offer our gratitude as well as our commitment that we will be the carriers of this tradition and we will ensure that this knowledge baton is passed on, is the active commitment that we carry, is what is expressed in the form of Acharya Runa, the third one.
Well summed up. Thanks.
And this is again connected to what he was referring to, the five yajnas that each one of us have to perform. That is the Deva Yajna, where the whole concept of yaga that he explained came in. And then there is Manushya Yajna. Manushya Yajna is the kind of offering that we make towards all entire humanity. Then the third we have Bhuta Yajna, the kind of offering that is done to every living being. I mean, just see the Vedic vision, how all encompassive it is, that nothing is left out of the ambit. Everything is brought in, such an inclusive idea. And the last one was Brahma Yajna, the Yajna which is done in favor of continuing the knowledge tradition. So these are the five Yajnas and also connected with the three debts that we carry. Continuing the question a little more, Acharya, you, in this context itself, you mentioned that's why Gurukulams have to be there in order to carry this tradition. And you were a visionary who started an unconventional system, which was not, which people were not familiar about 25, 30 years ago, how a Gurukulam could be, how it needs to be formulated. You came up with this idea. So can you explain us a little more about the importance of the Gurukulam and why that is required in the new age that is coming?
So much deliberation took place at Karnataka level in Bangalore. There were such great seekers, very humble achievers like Bharati Ramana Acharya and Professor Wedekar and Dr. Upen Shanai, and we all sat together and we have taken all those Indianness based educational experiments started by Mahatma Gandhi, Dayananda Saraswati, great Aurobindo, and even J. Krishnamurti. And after that, what that need-based passion now that we have formulated, for that we have started this type of Gurukula experiment, that which is Yuganukula, relevant to this time, which can address to the needs of the present time. That is how more than 2-3 years on every month we used to sit and we have formulated the philosophy part, then science part. There we have started research and all this probing and proving. When these two parts are well taken care of, well structured, we started experimenting. That is called technology. Three stages we have. Now this third part is very well taken care of by the society, large. When we started this, we have started Arishila for children. That is for our sisters, our children. And then for boys, we started Prabodhini on the bank of Tungabhadra near Shankaradhama, Shingen. Veda Vidyana Gurukulam, it was while celebrating Silver Jubilee of Janaseva. And in the same time, there are many, many such organizations, great ashramas, great pashalas in many areas. That too near Himalayan ranges, there are many great masters. They have done so much experiments. As a culmination of this whole process for many decades, in 2017, we organized a very big conference in that Mahakala Dhama, Ujjaini, Madhya Pradesh, where more than 300 organizers of various gurukulas assembled, where I could share our experiment, and where our great spiritual masters from all across all Mata Sampradaya, they were there, and very great social reformers, all Sangha elders were there. There I could give why Gurukulam, how Gurukulam, what Gurukulam, katham kim bhavayet, kena bhavayet, katham bhavayet. These three questions were well addressed in my deliberation there, well received. And then afterwards I have been made as the chief of that one. And now Nagpur is the head office. Again, when of Jaini also we have our main centers, and very great thinkers are with us, and we are connectivity with all such like-minded organizations and the seekers. That is how Gurukula started marching ahead now. People also understanding, parents also understanding now. Now that is the only panacea. There is no any other alternative. Nanya pantha vidyajayanaya. That is why now we have to think, bring that type of revolution. And already in Pondicherry, what experiment has been done, that is also very great. I am very much trained there. So that I am acquainted with the whole philosophy, like that many people like my doing. So we, as the cultural ambassadors from this Karnataka Gurukula, we must take up this responsibility. And now we are a happy young generation is coming up, leadership is taking up this mission. So this as a mission, we have to take and go ahead.
Thank you, Acharya. For the benefit of those who joined a little later, I would like to once again mention that Acharya ji is the founder of Veda Vijnana Gurukulam, a gurukulam which is very close to Bangalore. And this gurukulam is for students at the advanced level. And students enter here at the age of 16 or 17 and they continue their education for next 8 years, which also includes training into research and after they complete their masters. So, and we have two more gurukulams, the junior gurukulams, one for girls that is near Mangaluru in a place called Murkaje, and it is called Maitreyi Gurukulam, where students enter the Gurukulam at the age of 10 and they continue their education for next 12 years. It's a 12-year rigorous education, and by the time they come out, they are experts, scholars in their fields. And similarly, we have a Gurukulam for junior boys that is in Hariharapura, which is very close to the Sringagiri, the pilgrimage center, and it is called as Prabodhini Gurukulam, where again the students enter at the age of 10 and they continue their education up to next 12 years with specialization in either in agriculture, in yoga, or Ayurveda. So these are the emerging fields that are being Kala Kaushalam in arts as well. But all the three Gurukulams have the five principled approach in the education, and there the main approaches are: the first one is Veda, teaching of the Vedic knowledge, then Vijnana. One of our friends attendees had asked this question, is modern curriculum is also included? Yes, it is very much included. Vijnana, modern sciences, the sciences of the tradition, both are brought together. Synthesis has been established, that is Vijnana. Then we have yoga as the third stream, where youngsters will be educated, trained in the practice of yoga, which is an integral approach, not just the practice of asanas, but the focus would be on how one can control the mind, master the mind, and all the allied practices. So that is Veda, Vijnana, yoga. And one more important thing which is missing in modern education is agriculture or Krishi. Hands-on experience to work, to connect with nature, and that is the Krishi. Agriculture is the fourth stream, and the fifth stream is Kaushala, skill education, hands-on experience, working with things and gaining skills. It could be skills in music, it could be skills in arts, it could be skills of various other kinds. So this is called Panchamukhi Shikshana, five-faceted education, which is being practiced in all the three Gurukulams. This is a very brief introduction to the Gurukulam, but the real experience could be had only when you can visit the Gurukulam. So this is an open invitation to all of you to visit our Gurukulams, and these are emerging as the model education for the new future. And there was also one more question to which I would like to add. These Gurukulams are open to everyone. There is no any kind of limitation or reservation to admitting students. Only requirement is the interest, commitment, and competency, and the willingness of the parents and the children to commit their lives to further this education. That is the only requirement, but it is open to all castes, all genders. We have specific Gurukulams for girls, specific Gurukulam for boys, but it is a free progress kind of an education where a student learns on his own pace, something which is very revolutionary compared to what conventional systems we have today. And Acharya ji is one among the founders of these Gurukulams. Acharya ji, do you want to add anything about the Gurukulams?
Yes, one more thing, very important, is when some young girl or boy takes up our Rishi knowledge, like Vedas and Vedangas, and for them, it is societal duty to motivate them and arrange everything so that without any problems, without any hurdles, they can study. That is why in our Gurukula Parampara, we call it everything Nishulka. That is Ahara and Vasavyavastha, food and other facilities, amenities, it must be free of cost. It is only just to repay our indebtedness to our Rishi Parampara. It is the duty of society, well-wishers who are very much committed to preserve this tradition. Such philanthropists, donors, they will come forward and take care of all these amenities in all these areas. That is why Gurukule Ya Vidya Pradiyate Yam Vidyam Chhatraha Swikurvanti Desham Ayam Rushi परंपरा प्रदत्त अधिकार दैट दे विल बी टेकन केयर ऑफ देयर मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट्स विल बी एड्रेस्ड बाय पीपल सोसाइटी एट लार्ज दैट वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट टू बी अंडरस्टूड सो दैट वी हैव फोर पुरुषार्थ धर्म अर्थ काम मोक्ष सो फोर स्ट्रीम्स रिलेटेड knowledge basis here. Those who take care of this moksha vidya and dharma vidya, such students must be properly taken care of by well-wishers and philosophers of the society. Artha kama vidya also there, duly taken care of in our lineage. That is why Chanakya's artha shastram, Vatsyayana's kama shastram, everything has its own place in our education. But their students must pay. That is the real understanding here. So that for college students, for modern study stakeholders, they have to pay and they have to take. So for Vidya Prapti, there are three. Guru Shushrushaya Vidya, Pushkalena Dhanenava, Athava Vidya Vidya. Three. So that in Gurukula, we have this type of Vidya. Vidya means it is Vidya Vidya. Every child, it brings that lineage also. It represents that Rishi Parampara. That is what we say. Dhamani dhamani mein Rishi Parampara bahati dhara hai humare samaj mein, humare vyaktitva mein. So, we have to preserve that. This particular path also must be conveyed to the larger society.
Very true, Acharya. Just as we were referring to one foundational principle of the Gurukulam, that is Panchamukhi Shikshanam, five-faceted education, another important dharana or principle of the Gurukulam is this. In the tradition, three things were not to be sold: knowledge, food, and medicine. This forms the foundational belief of the Gurukulam, that in the Gurukulam, we will not have any fees for any of these. So just to make it very clear, the entire stay at the Gurukulam, education at the Gurukulam, and preliminary medical requirements of students, everything would be taken care of by the Gurukulam itself. In Veda Vijnana Gurukulam, we have about 70 students. In the other two Gurukulams, we have nearly about 120 to 130 students in each Gurukulam. So roughly around 500 students, 400 to 500 students in all the three Gurukulams, and this entire cost of their stay, of their education, is taken care of by the Gurukulam through the support, generous support of the society. And so far it's been nearly 30 years that these Gurukulams have been running, and we have had no difficulty in running because society has always come forward and willing to shoulder this responsibility. This is one of the markers which really give the Gurukula a very unique place in the modern world. Knowledge for the sake of knowledge, knowledge without any involvement of finances. I think this is something that really should enlighten our lives and also see how best this value or this principle can extend into modern education or the education of the day also. So with this, I thank profusely. I mean, thanking is not a word enough. I just offer my Sashtanga Pranam Namaskara to Acharya for being with us this morning and for sharing us his insights and his wisdom on the occasion of Guru Purnima, and also conveying the importance of a new education system that is required, which is rooted in the Indian tradition, yet modern, yet has its fruits to the modern world.
I was very tempted, Vinaya, to add there that another very important feature of this Gurukula education that was inspired by different teachers, and in the Gurukula, at the Veda Vidyana Gurukula, they practice, is the fact that knowledge was not meant always to have a job. The purpose of knowledge is to enlighten the being, to know more, to expand one's thinking. And all education had two parts. One was known as apara vidya, which is knowledge about technical things, and the other was about para vidya, which is about knowing yourself. modern education typically only focuses on the second one. As a result, we have fragile personalities. In the Gurukulam, we have teachers who help us to connect to our deeper selves, not only by imparting information, which is the feature of a lot of modern educational institutions, unfortunately, but by being acharyas themselves. And that is one definition, that understanding of the role of a teacher. A teacher can be an adhyapaka who just teaches for salary and leaves. Another teacher is an acharya who leads by example. And we are extremely privileged that we have had the blessings of Acharya Ramachandra Bhatt with us through our journey. And the last kind of a guru, the last kind of a teacher is the guru, one who is able to enlighten us from our and remove the fundamental ignorances within us. So these are the three kinds of teachers that are recognized in the tradition. And education, true education, included the yogic aspect, which was about connecting to your own self, which is the source of the all knowledge eventually. So for these few words, Acharya, I would also take this occasion to offer my Shashtanga Pranam to you also for all the guidance that you have done with the greatest of generosities. So I'm extremely grateful to you and to the entire Gurukula fraternity for their warm welcome and what you do for society today. Thank you. Selflessly.
Abhinandanani. Sarvebhyah Pratibhagibhyah Sarvabhya Pratibhaginibhyah. Om Swasti.
So Acharya conveyed his heartfelt congratulations to all those participants who have connected themselves to this Mahayajna, to this big offering to knowledge that we have been doing for the last few days since we have started. Now it's more than 2 weeks that we have started this journey. So thank you for being here. Thank you for listening to our masters. Thank you for also allowing yourselves to be enlightened by this ancient and very uplifting yoga tradition. So I hand it over to Vinaya to take over from there.
Thank you very much. As many of you are asking about the details of the Gurukulam, I have just shared the website and the contact details of the Gurukulam on the chat box. You can always connect with the Gurukulam using the email ID that has been provided there. The current principal, Vidwan Dr. Mahabaleshwara Bhatt, I have given his phone number also. So those who are interested to make contributions, who want to connect with him, who want to understand the Gurukulam, or if you want to send your children there, you're most welcome. And please plan to visit this Gurukulam whenever it is appropriate. It is one of the unique institutions, in fact, not just the Vedavijnana Gurukulam, but all the three Gurukulams which are there in the most scenic, beautiful places, whether it is the Maitreyi Gurukulam or the Prabodhini Gurukulam, they are the places to be visited. They are the educational pilgrimage centers that we all need to see how a Gurukulam has blossomed in the modern times as well. And I also would like to add, the students who have completed this from this Gurukulam are highly sought after. They hold positions from way in various places, including India and abroad. They are most of them are in the teaching and research profession, and some have written books. Some have come up with very many new ideas which are contributive towards the society. So this is definitely a very unique, successful experiment that we can see in the modern times. And with this very brief introduction to the Gurukulam as well, I request Acharya Ji to share a parting message, a blessing on this day. Before that, I would like to make the announcement of the next event, and then I go back to Acharya Ji seeking his last message of the day. So this afternoon, we have with us Saraswati Vasudevan Ji, who will be presenting on essence of yoga therapy. She is the founder of Yoga Vahini Chennai a very well-known yoga institute formulated on the lines of Krishnamacharya yoga tradition. She has been a student of Krishnamacharya, Desikacharya especially, for a long time, and she will be offering this session on essence of yoga therapy. And in the evening, we have Dr. Subhashkar, one of the big names in the world of science, computer science especially, and also about his expertise and knowledge in the fields of philosophy and humanities too. He will be speaking on yoga and science of consciousness in the slot 7 to 8 p.m. So these are the programs of the day. I really urge you to connect, join, and make use of this festival of these sessions, and invite others as well to partake in this yajna. What Acharyaji was referring, the way of the future is yoga, yaga, that is yajna, and tyaga, that is sacrifice. So this is definitely an offering which many such scholars are making in this month-long festival. So please do partake in this yajna and make the most of it. With this, I go back to Acharyaji Ramchandra Bhatji for a parting message, something that people can reflect upon the entire day and carry with them.
लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो स्वास्थ्यं परिसर विज्ञानं हेल्थ एनवायरमेंटल अवेयरनेस वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नाउ व्हाट दैट फिनिश या योगा यागा चा दिस मंत्र वी कैन टेक एज फुड स्टफ फॉर आवर ह्यूमन जर्नी ओम स्वस्ति
Thank you, Acharya.
I would just like to come here and say that we offer our gratitude not just to our teachers, but to our parents who have been there as the first gurus, and they will always be there for us at every moment. So my pranams to our knowledge gurus and to those to our parents who have brought us to where we are today. So bahu dhanyavadaha, Acharya.
शुभमस्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु.